The story that you are about to hear is a compilation of documented true facts, featuring characters, events, or places that has played a role in shaping history. Please sit back and listen as I recite this narrative for you. The Ourang Medan was a rumored ghost ship that, according to various sources, became a shipwreck in Indonesia, the waters of the Malacca Strait, or elsewhere after its entire crew died under suspicious circumstances in either June 1947 or February 1948, the precise time frame remaining unknown. Depending on which report is correct, a strange radio message was received by a number of ships traveling through the Malacca Strait, which is located around Sumatra in Malaysia, in either June 1947 or as late as February 1948. The origins of this message, an SOS, were unknown at that time. The message itself was divided into two parts, separated by unreadable Morse code. Those that received this message insisted that the transcript went: "All officers, including captain, dead. Lying in chart room and on the bridge, probably whole crew dead." This was followed by a burst of indecipherable Morse code, followed by a final bleak message: "I die." After this chilling conclusion, nothing else was transmitted. The terrifying distress call was picked up by two American ships, as well as listening posts in the United Kingdom and the Netherlands. The men manning this post were able to triangulate the source of these broadcasts and deduced that they were most likely coming from the SS Ourang Medan, a Dutch freighter navigating the Malacca Straits. The Silver Star, an American merchant ship, was dispatched to the coordinates. Given the nature of the distress calls, the captain of the Silver Star wasted no time in rerouting the ship to the new course. Several hours later, the Silver Star's lookout spotted the stranded Ourang Medan. Even as the rescue ship approached, there were no visible signs of life. All efforts to contact the crew failed, forcing the captain of the Silver Star to organize a search party. When the search party boarded, it was clear that the message had been horribly accurate. The bodies of the Dutch crew were strewn across the decks of the Ourang Medan. The victims' eyes widened in horror and their faces twisted in terror. Their arms had attempted to repel something. Even the ship's dog was terrified by whatever had happened. The canine was discovered to be in the midst of snarling at the cause. The boarding party discovered the captain's body on the bridge, while the bodies of his officers were strewn about the wheelhouse and the chart room. The communications officers remained at his post, as lifeless as the others, his fingertips resting on the telegraph. According to reports, all of the corpses had the same terrified, wide-eyed expressions as the crew on deck. Several things stood out to the rescue team as they made their search. The temperature in the area was well above 100 degrees Fahrenheit, but members of the team felt a foreboding chill coming from somewhere. Another mystery was the victims' conditions. There was no obvious evidence of injury or foul play. They were also decomposing faster than they should have. The ship itself did not appear to have been damaged. When the search party returned to the Silver Star, they quickly decided to salvage the Ourang Medan. Only after tethering the ships together did they discover smoke below decks, specifically in the number 4 cargo hold. The Ourang Medan exploded seconds after they severed the tow rope. The sheer force lifted it out of the water before it sank to the seafloor. The Ourang Medan's watery grave effectively erased the freighter from the face of the earth, relegating it to the realm of myths and legends. In May 1952, the United States Coast Guard made the first official mention of the incident. In addition to witness testimony about the crew members' conditions, the account included some bleak details. Their frozen faces upturned to the sun, staring as if in fear. Their mouths were gaping open and the eyes staring. One of the arguments against the event's veracity came from the Ourang Medan registry. Officially, the ship does not appear to have existed, despite the fact that the Silver Star was a real vessel. However, at the time the Ourang Medan was said to be sinking, the Silver Star was operating under a different registration, Santa Juana. The Grace Line Shipping Company had bought rights to the vessel and renamed it. Those who believe in the Ourang Medan story, on the other hand, insist that the ship's registration originated in Sumatra. Sumatra was a Dutch colony that was part of the Dutch East Indies at the time. Ourang means man in Indonesian, and Medan is the largest city in the islands of Sumatra. As a result, Ourang Medan literally means man from Medan. Author and historian Roy Bainton, who has conducted some of the most exhaustive and revealing research on the SS Ourang Medan, ran into dead ends after dead ends in his pursuit of the true story of the dead ship. He began by looking in the usual places, but couldn't find any mention of the ship in Lloyd's shipping registers or the Dictionary of Disasters at Sea between 1824 to 1962. He then contacted the United Kingdom Admiralty, the Register of Shipping and Seamen, at the National Maritime Museum in Greenwich, all of which informed him that the only place to check Dutch shipping records was in Amsterdam. Bainton searched the Dutch records as well as the Singapore Maritime Authority without success. Just as Bainton was about to abandon his investigation and dismiss the whole thing as a hoax, he was contacted by Professor Theodor Sarsdorfer of Essen, Germany, who had been pursuing the case for the better part of 50 years and was the first to reveal the names of the two American ships that had heard of the Ourang Medan's SOS calls. Sarsdorfer also directed Bainton to a 32-page German booklet titled Das Totenschiffen der Südsee, or Dead Ship in the South Sea, written by Otto Mielke in 1954. Mielke appeared to be well-versed in the Ourang Medan's route, cargo, tonnage, and engine power, as well as, allegedly, the captain's name. One is forced to wonder whether or not Mielke had contact with one of the Silver Star's notoriously difficult-to-find crewmen. The booklet suggests that potassium cyanide and nitroglycerin were stored and transported by the SS Ourang Medan and were on board at the time of the incident. Needless to say, this was a dangerous enough concoction in a laboratory with strict safety protocols, but in a cargo hold on the high seas, it was a potential nightmare, one that could explain not only the mysterious death of the Dutch crew, but also the subsequent explosion that claimed the freighter herself. According to Bainton, the Ourang Medan may have been smuggling nerve gas or even more insidious biological weapons manufactured by a sinister assembly of Japanese scientists whose experiments were so heinous that many of the atrocities committed by the Nazis and the name of science paled in comparison. This diabolical faction was unassumingly referred to as Unit 731. Unit 731, known to the locals as a den of cannibals, was founded in 1932 by Shir Ishii, a brilliant but misguided Japanese bacteriologist. The unit was intended to be a clandestine research and development department whose sole mission was to develop the most lethal chemical and biological weapons known to man, ensuring Japan's victory over any potential enemy. If this is true, it would certainly explain the ship's sudden demise, as well as provide evidence of a cover-up of the vessel's records. Bainton speculated that the US government, or another world power, may have decided to use a slow and inconspicuous vessel like the Dutch freighter to transport such hazardous cargo for reasons of both safety and concealment. He speculated that seawater may have entered the ship's hold, reacting with the dangerous cargo to release poisonous gases, causing the crew to suffocate. At this point, the rushing salt water could have reacted with the nitroglycerin, resulting in the explosive effect that was said to be responsible for the ship's eventual demise. World War II was in full swing at that time, along with a tense international climate. Any use of such sensitive materials being transported would have sparked public outrage and foreign outrage. It's possible that the SS Ourang Medan's details are nearly impossible to find because someone, somewhere, wants them to be. The Ourang Medan did not exist to the outside world because there is no concrete evidence of its existence. It's as if the ship itself is a ghost. The Silver Star's logs are devoid of any mention of the SS Ourang Medan rescue attempt. No Silver Star crew members ever shared any relevant information with the media. So if the Ourang Medan didn't exist, why did the Coast Guard mention it in 1954 and then the CIA in 1959? For a ship that never sailed, it has left many unanswered questions. While the SS Ourang Medan was a Dutch freighter transporting goods, it has been claimed that those goods could have been dangerous chemical weapons used in warfare. As a result, many theories contend that the Dutch crew was only hired to conceal the ship's true purpose. smuggling top secret goods from a defeated Japanese empire for the benefit of the American military during World War II. A pirate attack is certainly possible, but according to rescuer accounts, the crew's bodies were largely unharmed, which is unusual for a pirate boarding. The possibility of a supernatural event has been raised, but it is nearly impossible to confirm given the vessel's end-of-life secrecy. Even today, conspiracy theorists and paranormal investigators wonder what happened to the SS Ourang Medan. Ghosts, government hoaxes, and even alien invasions have been called into question. The crew of the Ourang Medan was asphyxiated by clouds of noxious methane that gurgled up from a fissure on the seafloor and poisoned the sailors before eventually engulfing the ship, according to those who believe the demise of the Dutch freighter was explicable by natural means. As terrifying as the idea of random bursts of methane destroying vessels after killing the crew is, it seems far-fetched because it does not account for the thunderous blast described by the Silver Star's crew. So, if it wasn't methane bubbles that caused the disaster, it could have been a boiler fire. In his 1965 book, Invisible Horizons, author Vincent Gaddis proposed that the ship's demise could have been caused by an undiscovered fire or failure in the ship's boiler system. He claimed that carbon monoxide could have leaked into the cabin, killing everyone on board while the fire slowly grew, eventually igniting the fuel and causing the ship to explode. After all is said and done, no one knows what happened to the Ourang Medan and her crew, but whatever the truth is behind this inexplicable tragedy, it remains one of the most perplexing and downright terrifying maritime mysteries of the 20th century. And, while it may not be as well known as the plethora of other ghost ships said to ply the high seas, it is just as real. Hey everyone, I just wanted to say that I am incredibly grateful that you took time out of your schedule to listen to my narration. This is Nikki of Twysted Mind, wishing you a great rest of your day. Salamat.